Hi friends, this is Gail O'Neill, and I teach stamping. I hope you enjoy. So, the black ice technique, I forget the name of the demonstrator who started it, but it uses Versamark and Stazon, and then you need to use the silver, gold, or copper cardstock. So what the original one was is you start with your piece and you put your stays on, which I'm going to do, and then you stamp your image, and then you take Versamark and do the same thing but slowly bring it down. I'm not very good at that, and I got one of them that really came out okay. This one, you know, was missing spots. It's kind of hard to see, but I think my hand was heavy in some spots. It's kind of hard to drag that. This smaller one came out pretty good. But when I saw this, I went, wait a second. We have something that makes that same look, and it's this embossing folder, Subtle. So with that, I did most of these cards. This one. This is another quick technique I'm going to show you. And for this one, instead of using that folder, I used a stamp, which really made it easy. But this whole technique with coloring inside, I'm going to show you a little bit. I will be doing a separate video on that. But you can see that I did play a lot. Using the Stazon, it's a very sticky ink, so a lot of times it came up, and even with the Stamparatus, it kept pulling the same spot up. I also, here's some other ones. This was with the stamp. I used, where is it? Right in front of me somewhere? Probably not. Yes. I used a stamp from Lily Pad Lake for this one. That stamp. So that kind of gave it, you know, a look. So that's, you know, another idea for someone if they wanted to try doing it that way. I may try a few other cards with that one, but I really love, between the stamp, I'm like torn, and this Subtle folder. So the two cards that I am doing tonight are, we'll start with this one. This seems to be everybody's favorite. And this stamp set, of course the stamp set disappeared. Here it is. Peaceful Place. It's really a cute set. If you want to, you know, color. I'm waiting for my new whatchamacallits, colored pencils to do some with this. So that's that set. Okay, so let me get started with this so I'm not keeping us all here all night. All right, so I'm going to start out. This is a piece 3x4. And I think I lost one of the pieces for that. Nope, that's good. Maybe not so much. Maybe not so much. I think I mixed them up. Better. Okay. So you start out. Most of the people that I've seen do it, tape theirs down with a temporary tape. I've just been kind of holding it and just doing the top and letting it come down just a little bit and turning it and going to the side. I don't like as much of the black all over. I don't know. I think it just hides the image. So with a very light hand, I kind of bring some of them some of them down. And you'll end up, and I get mad at myself when I get those little spots, but you don't really see them. So then you take the stamp itself, and again, ink it up with the stays-on. You want to make sure you get it really good. And you have to remember, it's slippery and sticky. So you want to go straight down. And then pull it up. So there's the image. Hopefully you can see it and there's not too much glare. And then you want to take it, make sure it's dry. Not as bad with the way I do it, but you will get, you know, lose some of that black if it's not dry. But definitely if you do it the other way, dragging the VersaMark down, then you're really going to pull that color up. So what I do, and even though this rolls, it flattens right out again. So I take the folder and the VersaMark pad and ink that up good. I love this subtle folder. This was like the best one they came up with. All right, then carefully you're going to place this down, and it will slip. And really, there's no way to tack it down because you have all that ink. So I just very carefully and lightly, and you can probably take, you know, a block or something and just rub it lightly over it. And then lift it up. And then I have a lot of clear embossing. And I probably bought this like 15 years ago in this big, big, big jar. So you can tell how little you really use. Okay, then I'm going to bring in the heat gun again. And there it is. And there's a spot I didn't get. And you can see it when you hold it up to the light. And there it goes. Okay, so you just let it cool a second. And then we can put it together. So I run a double coat because it is a thicker. So you can either, you know, use our tear and tape. But I just do a double coat of this. And then make sure that you kind of burnish it a little bit. Okay, and then I'm just going to do this one flat. I did dimensional up the other one. And this one I put through the subtle folder in advance. On the original card, I did it right on the card itself. this one I decided to add another piece, and I think this one I will dimensional just a little bit different look. Okay, so then I'm just going to attach this. And then I pre-did, if I can find it, and I did, do I want to, no, I'll just do it straight. I'm just going to trim it a little bit. And that's just a half inch piece. So sending prayers, just pretty simple, and that's that card. Okay, so how I did that one, which is that. And then for the next card, let's see. We're gonna do it on some gold. And this one I didn't score, so it's half a sheet. And I do like to score my cardstock. It gives a much better crease. And then it's at 4 1/4. So I'll put that aside. And this one I'll do with the dots, although I really like it with this. You know what? You kind of get it. Let me do it on this. Just so you see what it or how I did it. I mean, if you have other stamps in your collection that you think might work. Like, definitely try it. All right, I'm going to put the powder on it and lay it aside because you did see a few with the dots. I just don't want that ink to dry. Okay, so I'm setting that one aside and we're going to go ahead and do this one. So this was with Tuscan Vineyard. And again, I'm going to take the stays on. And put some of the black streaks. Mainly, I like the edging of it. And just a little bit of it coming down, not too much. I know me, I'll be getting heavy duty streaks. Okay, and then we're going to take, why'd I cover that up? So I'm going to take this little guy, ink him up, and the stays on. And again, you want to be careful that you don't wiggle it. But you probably heard that come up. It's so sticky. Okay. So we're going to dry it. And I'm drying it on low. And then again, I'm going to bring over the subtle folder. And ink it up again. Lay that down and rub. And make sure, again, you're holding it down so it doesn't smush. I mean, if it smushes to the side a little bit, it's not gonna really make that big of... And then, pretty. Okay, and then again, one nice thing, you don't have to worry about using the embossing buddy, which I always forget. But with this, you don't need it. Okay, then we're going to bring this over and... Let me get a better tool. So sorry about that. I don't know where that piece went. Okay, so we're going to mount this. And again, I'm going to do some doubles. Just to make it a little bit stickier. Now the other pieces, nope, that's here. Hi-ya-maya. All right, so this one can go regular. And we'll get that mounted. And then I took some linen thread and just wrapped it around the bottom. Okay, it's going to be a knot because I didn't leave a piece long enough there. And my fingers can't feel it. Okay, so we're going to trim that off. Okay, and then this gets mounted to that, and again, with the dimensionals. And I like to reinforce where the thread is. Gonna have to do a lot of editing in this video to get it on YouTube. Yeah, if you ever need to go back and watch any of my videos, you can go to YouTube, and I do edit them. Okay, and then for this piece, I need to put a cover on this because I'm laying things on it. This is very sad tonight that I am dropping things all over. Okay. So, I used the pretty, what is it called? Pretty something. Pretty label punch. So, I've already embossed it on there. And then what I did was cut straight down to get rid of that. And straight down to get rid of that. And that just gives you another use for this label punch. And then I took a little bit of Early Espresso and a sponge. And just went around the edges a little bit. Just so it's not as stark. And I think I want liquid glue on that. Just to make sure it stays onto the embossing. And then that goes there. So let me clear this off just a little bit. and I'll bring everything back in. Oh, here's another. When you have embossing powder, I use a Swiffer and just cut it into pieces, and that'll get all that, it'll pick up everything. Especially when you're doing any kind of glitter, it picks that up. Okay, so now we're nice and neat again, and I'll bring back some of these cards for you to see. And this and this. Pretty, right? And I do think I like the one I did tonight better. But that's really the technique, and it does look, I've never seen anybody's close up, you know, from the original, but I like the way this comes out. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you Wednesday night. Good night.